What's up, Clashers? Turn 56 from Iconic here, just with another brief little video about the most recent update, an update to my video about the update, if you will. Now that we've had a week or so to kind of work around with this, to kind of see what kind of changes have been made and how they're affecting us, I thought I'd just do another little video on this one. Couple points I wanted to cover. The first one, which is just awesome, this Clan War Attack Preview, that whole thing with the Be Ready or Be Sorry. Once you hit that attack button, you can't go in. I mentioned in the first video that would make it so you couldn't ghost anymore, meaning you couldn't turn off your Wi-Fi before you drop your troops, and then drop your troops and basically get a free attack out of it, because it was going to count that as attack. I have recently learned, since I did that last video, that this also seriously limits what you can do with certain mods, the Xmod, the Imod. Not only has it made it so you can't ghost with this, but this new update has changed how information is sent, apparently, from the servers to your iPad or your iPhone or whatever you're using to play Clash. So while those Xmods and Imods still work in the sense that you can attack the base free of charge and not have it count as a war attack, they do not trigger any traps or clan castle troops during those attacks. And that was the main advantage of those mods, is you could send them in, you could see where the traps were, you could see what the clan castle troops were, and then you could kind of tweak your army based on that, and then just keep attacking and attacking and attacking until you found a strategy that you thought could get you 3 stars. And all without any resource cost, because it wasn't a real attack and it didn't drain any of your resources while you were having to re-up that army, because it didn't actually use your army. Now you can still do that. You can still attack the base, I guess, with these mods as many times as you want, but the fact that you won't be triggering any traps or the clan castle is huge. That means these mods are essentially a waste, at least for the time being. Supercell has effectively hamstrung the mod users. They're not going to get the type of information that they need out of it, because they can practice the attack all they want, but if they're never going to trigger the bombs and the Teslas and the clan castle troops, they're not really going to be attacking the same base that they're going to attack once they actually use their war attack. So that's really good news for the fair play community. Everybody's pretty stoked about it. If you're using mods, then suck it. I don't care. So that's what I think about that. Another thing that we've noticed is, I don't normally spend a lot of time talking about farming, but we have seen with this, it's not on this news section here, but one of the things they did announce was they're going to make the matchmaking for multiplayer a little more even, so you'll be more likely to meet your own town hall level or something very close to it. And we have seen a significant increase in players who are dropping way down in cups, which used to be kind of a waste of time, because you could drop way down into, as a town hall 9, you could drop down into bronze, but it would take you maybe 50 to 100 searches to find a base worth finding, because most of what you were going to find down there was going to be town hall 5s and 6s that aren't worth your time. Well, now that you're more likely to find other town hall 9s down there, or town hall 8s or 10s or whatever, it means there's a lot more bases at the low levels you can take advantage of. That means more people who are inactive, more people who have closed down accounts, who are just letting their collectors and mines accumulate free gold, basically. So that's really changed the way a lot of people are going to be farming, I think. And then lastly, I'll talk about how the war matchups have been affected. Supercell, probably being aware of all the 8.5s that are out there these days, have decided to change how they determine the war strength with their algorithms. They have now assigned a value to your walls, whereas there was none before, and they have apparently increased the value given to your offensive troops, your heroes and your actual troops, to try to try to combat the number of 8.5s that were out there. But after several wars, it seems like the 8.5s are still having an effect in our matchups anyways at Iconic. We are still seeing real advantages for us in the low-level Town Hall 9s for our 8.5s versus other people who are rushing right into building expos and not really wasting or not really investing their resources in offense and in walls. We're still seeing a strong advantage for us on the lower level Town Hall 9s as far as the war map goes. So it doesn't look like the 8.5 theory is dead yet. I would still strongly recommend, even after this update, that you guys use the 8.5 technique. Watch my video on how and why to be an 8.5. I think it's still going to be very effective. After all, this game is still about offense over defense, even with that tweak that Supercell put out. As far as the air sweeper goes, we haven't seen any above level 2 yet, I don't believe, because people aren't really wasting time on gemming them. So it's kind of hard to tell how effective they're going to be. I still believe that people were overreacting to the air sweeper update. Oops. And it's not going to be as detrimental to the La Lune attacks as a lot of people thought. We've seen several La Lune attacks still successful in our wars, even when they're going right at the air sweepers. They're an annoyance, yes, but at least so far, they're not such a hindrance that La Lune is dead. You just have to be a little more strategic, a little more precise in your attacks. No more spam Laloon, which in my opinion is a good thing. So that's my update to the update, you guys. I'm just so happy this modding thing is has been tackled by Supercell. It's past due. It's an easy fix, but I think they did a great job with this update, making it easier for Fair Play clans to really show their skills and be able to use their, smart attacks and their experienced attacks effectively, as opposed to letting these modders take them over. So bring on the modders now is what I say, because they haven't learned how to do it yet on their own, and now they're at a big disadvantage. All right. Thanks for watching, you guys. Turd56 saying keep on clashing.